plumber, carpenter, doctor. Mario has worn many hats throughout his life, but he always does so as a hero.
Except for that time he tortured an animal, but no one really talks about that.
Born as one of the 7 star children possessing an extraordinary amount of power
and extra horrible crying fits,
Mario was assuredly destined for greatness.
Then him and his little bro Luigi wound up in New Donk City, where he spent his days throwing shit at monkeys and, fixing toilets. Not exactly the great heroic destiny I was expecting, but hey, at least his girlfriend was smoking.
But everything changed after a chance meeting with Princess Peach Toadstool. Her Mushroom Kingdom had been conquered by Bowser, the tyrannical King of the Koopas, and her only hope of rescue lay in the hands of the Mario Brothers.
And Mario had all the power he needed to take the Turtle Terror down. He's super tough, super quick, and really, really strong. He can jump several times his own height, smash tanks to bits with his butt, and toss Bowser around as if he's a featherweight.
So long, Bowser.
Needless to say, the Mushroom Kingdom was in good hands.
So was the princess. She even gave Mario a piece of her cake. Yeah, if you know what I'm saying. Get in there, buddy. You deserve it all. Oh, come on. It's an actual cake. That's good, too, I guess.
And if his strength doesn't cut it, Mario has plenty of extra weapons and powers on hand.
He can already shatter brick with his bare fists, but when he needs the power to break down the toughest walls, he busts out the Ultra Hammer. Sounds like a wrestling move Lou Albano would have used back in the day. Rest in peace, Kevin.
Forged by 2 master blacksmiths, the Ultra Hammer, combined with Mario's mighty swing, can break through practically any material.
And he's got a ton of awesome power-ups, like that spicy fire flower.
Actually, while Mario used to need this flower, he has since learned how to use pyrokinesis without it.
Well, the ice flower lets him freeze enemies, the lucky bell turns him into a kitty cat, and the super mushroom gives him a power boost and increases his size. Yeah, I bet the princess likes that one.
With his frog suit, his swimming ability increases dramatically. With the double cherry, he can create clones of himself with no power decrease. With the stopwatch, he can freeze time. With the cape feather or the wing cap, he can soar to new heights. And with the Starman or Rainbow Star, he becomes totally invincible for a short time.
And with the gold flower, he never has to work another day in his life because he's got an infinite supply of money made of people.
While he can carry several power-ups at once, Mario doesn't always need them to prove his potential.
He's quick enough to maneuver when transformed into a bolt of lightning, and skilled enough to pilot the Star Diver as it rockets through the atmosphere. He's so freaking manly, he took an explosion to the face that wrecked an entire castle. And even better, he was standing in the middle of this.
Based on a standard tennis court's measurements, we can determine the blast of this fireball covered a radius of over 2,000 feet. To reach this distance, the blast must have had an explosive yield of over 2.4 megatons.
So what you're saying is Mario could totally play tennis with a nuclear warhead for a ball and be totally fine?
Probably.
Finally, something that could actually get me interested in tennis! Let's try it out, Wiz!
Wait, do you have a nuclear bomb?
Well, you said yourself you wanted our 100th episode to be a blast, so come on over next week, and if we're still alive, we'll go over Sonic.